स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस रचना जैन, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट पीजी कॉलेज, राजगढ़, अलवर. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल टेल यू द समरी ऑफ द पोएम माई लास्ट टचेस. इट दिस वीडियो इज द सेकेंड वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन दिस पोएम. दिस पोएम इज मैंशनड in the syllabus of BA Part 3rd English Literature, Paper 1st, Unit A. My Last Duchess was published in Dramatic Lyric in late November 1842. In the first publication, it was entitled In Italy, and it was in the 1849 edition that the present title My Last Duchess was given. The speaker in this poem is the Duke of Ferrara, an important city of Italy. When the poet begins, the Duke of Ferrara is told a very powerful, proud and hard-hearted Italian Duke of the 18th century. He has been widowed recently, so he intends to marry a second time. The messenger of powerful count who has his estate in the neighborhood comes to the Duke's palace to negotiate with him the marriage of the count's daughter. The Duke takes him round his picture gallery and shows to him the portrait of his last duchess. The portrait is lifelike and realistic, and the Duke, who is a great lover of fine arts, is justly proud of it. The Duke points out the portrait to the messenger of the count and tells him that he alone uncovers the picture and nobody else is allowed to do so. At this point, the Duke notices an inquiring look in the eyes of the messenger and at once understands that he wants to know the cause of the deep, passionate look in the eyes of the Duchess and proceeds to satisfy his curiosity. In response to the inquiry look of the messenger, the Duke tells him that the deep, passionate look in the eyes of the Duchess does not result from a guilty love. He did not give her any occasion to be unfaithful to him. Even the portrait on the wall was alone done not by an ordinary artist but by a monk, and he was allowed only a single day to do it. He did not allow the monk any longer time, for he did not want to provide them any occasion for intimacy. This shows that the Duke is very jealous, and the poor Duchess could not have enjoyed any freedom of movement at the wife of such a man. Continuing further with his expectation, the Duke tells the messenger of the count that his last duchess had very childish and foolish nature. She was pleased with trifles. She thanks for everyone the slightest service they happen to render to her, and had no sense of dignity to her. For example, the faint flush of joy on her cheek and neck was not caused by the presence of her husband alone, but if the painter happened to mention that her cloak covered her wrist too much, and because of this her wrist look very beautiful, and he is unable to paint such pinkish glow in his painting, She would take such chance remarks as compliments and began to shy. She smiled at everything without any distinction. She thanked everyone in the same way. He expected a better sense from his wife. He did not correct her, even to notice such frivolity would have meant loss of dignity, and he did not like to suffer this loss. Besides, the Duchess would have argued and discussed with him instead of listening to his advice. Her habit of smiling continued to grow till it became intolerable to the Duke. At last, he gave order to stop her smile, and then all smiles stopped together. The line has been left intentionally vague. We cannot say for certain how the smiling stopped, but most probably the poor innocent Duchess was murdered at the command of her brutal and stony-hearted husband. The Duke then asked the messenger to come down where the other guests of the Duke are waiting. In passing, the Duke tells the messenger that he would expect a great dowry from his master, the Count, although, of course, he adds very cleverly that his primary interest or concern is in the daughter of the Count, not in the dowry. So the Duke is not only proud but also greedy and cunning. He is hypocrite of the first water. The only good point in him is his love of art. However, before they descend the stairs, the Duke calls the attention of the messenger to a bronze statue of Neptune, the sea god. The statue shows the god riding and controlling a seahorse. The Duke is very much proud of the statue, and he says that it is a rare statue, especially carved out on bronze for him by the famous sculptor Claus of Innsbruck. The Duke thus tries to impress the messenger with his artistic taste. So now I have told you the complete story and summary of the poem My Last Duchess, so that you can understand the explanation easily. In the third video, I will explain you the entire poem in two parts. Thank you for listening my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.